Hello and a very warm welcome to you. I'm Hayley Palmer. Really good to have you here with me on the show this evening, especially as we are joined by winner of The Voice, Molly Hocking. And here is what happened when I caught up with her. Molly Hocking, it's great to have you on the show. How are you?
Thank you so much for having me. It's so nice to see you again.
I know. When I first met you and your mum, your lovely mum, I think it was about this time last year, and we just instantly all got on. We even went to Nando's, didn't we?
Of course we did. Honestly, we had, me and mum had like a date night planned that night with my housemate, so we absolutely threw that off and went to Nando's with you because it was the best thing at the moment. So
I mean, yeah. I'm sorry about my eating habits. I think double chips, loads of ketchups. You were like, what is she doing? But I was so hungry after filming with you.
You sent it back to the kitchen and got a better one back, so it's fine.
I did, didn't I? I'm a Nando's expert.
You're like, where's the salad? There's no salad in this veggie burger.
We've gone there already. Molly, it's so good to have you on the show. Now, I want to talk about you and what you've been up to in lockdown, because obviously it has been tough times, but you've been quite creative. I've seen you on Instagram. It's brilliant.
Yeah, well, lockdown obviously has been bloody difficult for all of us. And yeah. The first lockdown wasn't so bad because I had loads of things keeping me going, like loads of lives with companies like McVitie's and dance companies and singing companies. And I was like, yeah, this is going to keep me going for the rest of lockdown number one, not knowing that there was a lockdown number two and three coming. So when lockdown number one kind of lifted, I was able to go out and do stuff like gigs and go back up to London and record. And I wasn't able to finish the recordings before lockdown two came into place. And I just felt really lost in lockdown number two, really, really lost. And my kind of mental health went down the drain. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to spend time with my family, come off social media a bit. And by the time lockdown three came, I was like, you know what? It's time to get back on social media. No matter how I'm feeling, everyone's feeling kind of the same as me. So if I can help anyone in any way by posting a video, that's great.
Yeah, exactly. And I think it's good to get creative. And yeah, we're loving your live at 5 on Wednesdays, isn't it? That's when your Instagram lives is. We love that.
Honestly, I never planned it because I just tried to be real. And I always get special guests on, but last night I didn't. But next week I've got a really special guest. Ooh. So it's all fun and games at the moment. It's all up in the air and it's always a laugh.
Yeah. Oh, well, it's brilliant to have you here. And we're going to take a little trip down memory lane and look at some of your amazing songs. This one is Don't Know Why, Norah Jones cover. Just beautiful. We're going to check it out. And Molly and I will see you in a couple of minutes' time.
Waited till I saw the sun. Don't know why I didn't come. Left you by the house of fun. Don't know why I didn't come. I don't know why I didn't come. When I saw the brave day, wish that I could fly away. Instead of kneeling in the sand, catching teardrops in my hand, my heart. Didn't come, feel as empty as jump. Don't know why I didn't come. My heart.
I want to talk about what is coming up next for you. Really exciting. You're going to be touring with Ollie Murs in July when he comes to Cornwall.
Yes. He's got a massive tour coming on, and obviously due to COVID, I didn't know whether this was going to be postponed or cancelled. But thank the gods, it's going on, and I'm going to be his supporter at one gig in Cornwall at the Wilds on the 2nd of July. So come get your tickets and you won't regret it.
We won't regret it. We're going to be there. I think I have to come to Cornwall for this special occasion.
You do. Come down for that. Then you can stay with us in our spare room and then come up and camp with us. It's all good.
I mean, how can I turn that down?
You can't. So you have to be here.
I can't. I'm there. I'm so there, Moles. And what else can we expect moving forward? Because you're going to have some new songs out, like you mentioned.
Yeah, so planning forward, I've got basically one song a month going to come out. And I'm still in sessions. I'm still going up to London and meeting producers and songwriters and writing with them. So expect at least a song a month and some music videos and some funny clips on Instagram. And that's what you can expect for the next few months. So.
Yes. Well, we very much look forward to that. We're going to play out Songbirds, Eva Cassidy. Oh, I love this song.
It's my favourite song. Honestly, Eva Cassidy is my inspiration. So.
Oh. Well, let's check this out and we will see you in a couple of minutes' time.
For you.
Welcome back to At Home with Hayley. It's so good to have you with me on the show and brilliant to be joined by Molly Hocking on tonight's At Home with Hayley. We'll be catching up more with her after this.
Your skin makes me cry. You float.
Rewind how everything started for you. When I had a little chat with you last time, you told me that you were Mary in your school play. I was a shepherd in my school play, but you said that Marys always go on to do good things, and I think that's true.
Do you know what? I always kind of wanted to be the centre of attention when I was like 5 to 10 years old, and I don't know why that is, but in a good way, I think. I actually auditioned to be a star because I thought the stars were beautiful. But I got Mary. I actually cast as Mary. So I sang the song on stage. And my teachers came up to me at the end and they were like, Molly, you've got a really, really good voice for a 9-year-old. And I was like, I just sang the song, but thank you. You know what I mean? Like when you're a 9-year-old. And then I've got videos of it from when I was 9.
Oh,
mum and dad,
to see these.
Yes, I will send them so you can play them on here. And I just look back at it and I'm like, for a 9-year-old, I was an absolute star. And I don't think I am now, but I look back and I'm like, why didn't I think I was good then? And if I don't think I'm good now, why don't I think I'm good now? Because I'll look back in 10 years and think I was amazing now, you know?
Aww. Yeah, I mean, it's just brilliant. I think you just know when you've got that kind of talent and you can sing. I mean, I've always known that I can't sing, Molly. I'm literally tone deaf. It's never going to happen. But did you have singing lessons following that up? I mean, is it a natural talent or have you had a little bit of help along the way?
It's always been a natural talent, but I've had confidence issues in the past. So I went to a singing teacher for about a year and that only really helped with confidence. And I didn't really let it help with my singing because I don't really like being told what to do with my voice or my singing. I know that sounds stupid, but I kind of know my own.
You just know.
I know my own body and I know what sounds I like and I know what sounds I don't like. So I kind of go with what I'm feeling in the moment. And if someone tells me they don't like it and I like it at the time, I don't listen to that person because I'm like, I like it. So I'm going to put it out there.
You go, girl. Let's sort of fast forward to The Voice. How did that actually come about? Were you like, I'm going to audition, I'm going to go for it?
Do you know what? It was that a year before that, I auditioned for The X Factor and I had a massive letdown, And I became really ill from it. It made me physically ill. I was really ill. I was like, in bed for about 2 weeks after my letdown. And I was just like, you know what? Singing maybe just isn't for me. Maybe I should give up and just work in St. Ives. So I went to my auntie's deli in St. Ives, the allotment deli. And I worked there for a year. And I absolutely loved it. And it gave me my confidence back, like socializing with people, with customers. And that was probably the best thing I could have done at the time. But The Voice came down to my local pub, the smallest pub in St. Ives.
It's meant to be.
Yeah, exactly. And I was like, do you know what? Maybe I should just go down and like, just do it. Like, I'm not expecting anything anyway. So I went down
and
there.
And when you auditioned, did you know? Did you think, yeah, it's going well? Because you kind of get a bit of an inkling, don't you?
Do you know what? No, I didn't, because I had no voice at the time because the football was on the night before. The World Cup was on the night before. And I completely lost my voice. So I decided to sing Back to Black by Amy Winehouse and Upside Down by Paloma Faith, which is a song I still sing now. And I had no voice, but I was just like, do you know what? If it comes to nothing, I don't really mind because I've lost nothing. And if it comes to something, I've gained something. So, yeah.
Yeah. And look what happened. Winner. What? Which we're going to talk about more in a minute. I mean, just incredible. But we're going to play out Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, one of my favourite songs and my dad's favourite songs, an Elton John cover, so enjoy.
When are you gonna come down? When are you going to land? I should have stayed on the farm, I should have listened to my old man. You know you can hold me forever, I didn't sign up to you. I'm not a present for your friends to open. This boy's too young to be singing the blue. Society, how you can't plant me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my where the dogs of society howl. You can't plant me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my plow, back to the howling old owl in the woods, hunting the horny black toad. Oh, I firmly decide in my future lies beyond the yellow brick road.
More about you winning The Voice, Molly, because it's just incredible. And I just don't know how you even do it. If it was me and the chairs start turning round, I'd be like, oh my goodness, I think I just need to stop and take this in. But you're so professional, you keep going. I mean, Ollie Mers turned round, what, in about 5 to 10 seconds, didn't he?
Yeah, I know. And honestly, I stood on that stage, and before I started singing, I was like, what am I doing? I am going to let my family down. I'm going to let myself down if someone doesn't turn. So, and then I just thought to myself, do you know what? If someone doesn't turn, I've come all the way up here and I've put myself through this. So even if I don't get a turn, I will be so much stronger from it, because I've done so many things before. But then Ollie turned in about 4 seconds.
Aww.
And that made me even more nervous, because I was like, oh my God, he's actually Ollie, my icon. I've been to see him when I was like 13 at Powderham Castle. He's actually like watching me right now. I was like, Ollie, no
and
way.
Did you know you were going to go for Ollie? Because if it was me, I think I would have planned it on my way up there. I'm like, I'm going to go for Tom. I'm going to go for Ollie.
Yeah, I planned it. I was like, if Tom Jones turns, I would go for him, because my granddad has always told me that he's got the most experience, the most whatever. But he turned as well, and so did Jennifer. And I just thought, do you know what? I've got such an instant connection with Ollie. Yeah. And I want to marry him as well.
I mean, but he's a beautiful man. Can we just talk about Ollie here? He's so beautiful. And he just seems like such a nice person.
Do you know what? He is such the most lovely person. And he's so down to earth. I cannot describe him. He is amazing.
And your names match, Molly and Ollie. It's like meant to be, isn't it?
Exactly. But honestly, I wish him all the best, and he does for me as well. And we kind of support each other at the moment as well.
Yeah.
And I'm so thankful for that. But I'm so glad I chose him, because he turned first. I went for him and I didn't think that he would let go of me that easily. And that's the way it went.
And that point when you won, I actually watched it again on YouTube earlier today. And I was nearly crying, because like the actual tension and just your little face. I mean, your mum must have been so proud as well.
Do you know what? I've got a slow motion video of me winning. And just at the end of it, because the producer recorded a slow motion video behind the camera, and she sent it to me. And my brother came in last minute, and my brother never kind of like, you know, like brotherly love and all that. He never comes and like touches me or anything. He literally grabbed his hands around me and lifted me up, and I was just like, I have just done the impossible that I thought I'd never do in my life.
Oh, good old bro. Well, we're gonna play out your winning single, I'll Never Love Again, which is a live version of you singing this for us, Molly. So thank you so much, and we'll see you in just a couple of minutes time.
Wish I could have said goodbye. I would have said what I wanted to, maybe even cried for you. If I knew it would be the last time, I would have broke my heart in two, trying to save a part of you. Don't I feel another touch? Don't I start another fire? Don't wanna know another kiss? No other name.
What a show so far. It's lovely to have Molly Hocking with us, and you are in for an exclusive here. Enjoy.
It's a style that stands for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the sky. Hoping for the best, but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Can you imagine when the race is won? Turn a golden face into the sun. Praising our leaders, we're getting in tune. The music's played by the madman. Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really wanna live forever? Forever. Music's for the seven head.
welcome back to At Home with Hayley. What a show so far. Wonderful to be joined by Molly Hocking on tonight's show. We'll be catching up with her again after this.
Angels watching over me with smiles upon their face, 'cause I have made it through this far in an unforgiving place. Feel sometimes this is too steep for a girl like me to climb, but I must knock those guards right down. I do it in my own time. I don't care, I'm halfway there, on a road that leads me straight to who knows. Watching people scurry by, rushing to and fro. Oh, this world is such a crazy place. It's all about to go, go, go. Sometimes life can taste so sweet when you slow it down. You start to see things differently when you turn it round. I don't care, I'm halfway there. I'm just soaking up the magic in the air. Slow it down, yeah, yeah, yeah. Then you pick it up.
Amazing single After the Night Before. I mean, it actually sounds like you've gone out all night, which is probably what we will do after June, but it's not, is it? It's a really vulnerable, lovely song.
Do you know what? At the time that I heard the name of the single, I was like, do you know what? It sounds like people are going to be like, they've been out all night and they've been having a drink and they've gone back with a random person. But it's not all about that. It's about the feeling behind being with someone that you don't feel appreciates you as much as you appreciate them, almost. And I've been in that situation at least 3 times. So I thought I had to write a song about it and get it out. And that's the first thing I got out, so.
Yeah, and I think that is such a relatable song for people, isn't it? And people could be going through really hard times and lockdown and stuff. So it's a really song that we could connect with.
Exactly. And I just thought, do you know what? It's not only a song about connecting to whether you've been with someone. It's about connecting to a sort of feeling or something. I just didn't want it to be a song about someone. I wanted it to be a song about everyone, you know, connecting. So,
yeah. And when you perform this on The Voice, I was so proud, Molly. I was sat there watching you on TV and I'm like, there's Molly and she looks so beautiful. And that song was just so polished and I just really feel like you did yourself proud.
Do you know what? It was done in one take and I was just like, after one take, I was like, do you know what? it is what it is, and I want it to be live, and I want it to be the most vulnerable I can make it. So let's just do it in one take, and that's good for me. But you know what? The moment I went on that stage at The Voice, I was walking up the stairs, and I tripped and fell, and I pierced my leg.
No!
And I did. And it was so bad that they said I needed to get stitches.
Oh, Molly!
So I've got quite a big scar at the moment, but they managed to bandage it up before I sang, and then I kind of kept a plaster over it, but it was like, it was a dent in my leg, but I still carried on, you know what I mean?
You're such a professional.
I am a professional.
Keep going, no matter what. Well, we want everyone to download your single. We're going to put details on the screen below of how you can do that, because we want to support Molly. It's such a great song. We want everyone listening to it, don't we, Moles?
Yes, and I've got more songs coming out in the next few weeks, like every month. So keep on my Spotify, keep on my streams, and yeah. Have fun.
Watch the space. Brilliant. Well, we're going to take a look at your video after The Night Before. It's so beautiful. Enjoy.
Hours is a long time to be waiting for somebody to call. Why do I forget what it feels like the morning after the night before? 'Cause whenever you call, it don't hurt anymore. I tell myself it's different, show up outside your door, and it's always the same. You tell me you've changed, myself believe you. Here we go again. I get that feeling in my stomach, lying on your chest, knowing that you're only gonna love me till the morning after the night before. I've told all my friends all about you. They're trying, but they don't understand why I keep on doing what we do. But they're not there when the phone's in my head. 'Cause whenever you call, it don't hurt anymore. I tell myself it's different, show up outside your door, it's always the same. You tell me you've changed, I make myself believe you. Here we go again. I get that feeling in my stomach, lying on your chest, knowing that you're only gonna love me till the morning after the night before.
Molly Hocking, it has been such a pleasure to have you on the show. Thank you so much. It's been a lovely trip down memory lane. Good to chat to you. I'm definitely coming to Cornwall, even though apparently there aren't any Nando's in Cornwall, but you're going to cook for me.
Yes, of course I am. I'm an absolute Gordon Ramsay at the moment, and Mary Berry can take a hat off to me, so I will definitely do that. And five-star chefery at your service, Hayley.
Okay, I'm going to let everyone at home know how we get on with that. And maybe I'll take some singing lessons off you, Molly, as well, if that's okay.
Yeah, karaoke. Five Live Wednesday.
Karaoke.
Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, let's do that. Have to. Five Live Wednesday with Hayley.
Okay, she's going to be horrified. Yes, we're so going to make that happen. Well, love to your mum and dad and the family.
Thank you
so much. It's been such a pleasure. We've had a real good laugh, and that's what we need in lockdown, isn't it?
Oh, exactly. Honestly, I'm all about a good laugh at the moment. It's all about lifting your endorphins, as you can do with exercise and chocolate. So do it more with chocolate at the moment.
I'm a chocoholic. I can relate to that. Well, I know, get me chocolate. Well, Molly, we want to remind everyone to download your single. Details are on the screen below of how you can do that. Also, follow Molly on Instagram because she's very entertaining, especially on a Wednesday night at 5 o'clock.
With my mum.
We're all going to be tuning in with your mum. Aw, love it. But thank you, Molly, for cheering us up. We just think you're brilliant. Thank you so much. It's Molly Hocking, everyone.
Thank you, Hayley.
Oh, huge thank you to Molly Hocking for being a great guest on tonight's show, and to you at home for supporting the show. It's so appreciated. Thank you. Now, this last song we are going to dedicate to Molly's mum, Sarah, because she is just wonderful. Thank you for everything, Sarah. And we will see you same time, same place next week.